start our political science new chapter, chapter first, power sharing. All are ready for my class? Okay. Today we start the new chapter, first chapter, power sharing. In our previous class, the ninth class, you have also got the ideas about the democracy, democratic rules, democratic system, all the things. But today we discuss about the power sharing. In our school system, we adopted different levels of the power sharing. Yes or no? Okay. In which type? Principal. Then vice principal. Session in charge. Teachers, then class teacher, in a school system we have in this type of power sharing system: principal, vice principal, session in charge, class teacher and subject teacher. This will give our good opportunity for the good service in our system. That means the power is shared in different hands. That is, in our democratic system, power sharing is very important. Yes or no? Okay, very important. What is the reason? Power sharing in different hands, it is helpful for the good services to the system. First of all, we can see the in a school system, we can divide the power in different ways: principal, vice principal, section in charge, class teacher and subject teacher. First we can discuss it about the power sharing. What do you mean by power sharing? Do you have any idea about power sharing? Okay, power sharing is the distribution of the power sharing in different government organs. Power sharing is the distribution of power in different government organs, that is the legislature, executive and judiciary. Distribution of power in different government organs, that is the power sharing of the system. Besides, power sharing is in a sharing of the power in different levels. Levels in different levels. Which are the levels? The main levels are central level, second one, state level, then third one, local level. First one, the power sharing. Power sharing is the distribution of power. Distribution of power in different government organs like legislature, executive and judiciary. Besides, the power sharing is the sharing of the power in different levels: central level, state level and local level. These are the first step for the power sharing. That means the defined first. This is the answer for the question. What do you mean by power sharing or the defined power sharing? All of them said? Okay. Today we are discussing the story of two small countries. One is Belgium and other is Sri Lanka. First one is Belgium and second one is, Belgium is a small European country and its capital is
Perth, Brussels, B-R-U-S-S-E-L-S, Brussels. Brussels is the capital of the Belgium. In Belgium, the borders of the Belgium are France, Netherlands, Luxembourg, then Germany. These are the borders of the Belgium. Belgium is a small European country. Its area is lower than the our state Haryana. Then the main borders of the Belgium are France, Netherlands, Luxembourg and also Germany. These are the borders of Belgium. Another important thing, in Belgium there are a special group of people living in the Belgium, which is an ethnic group. Ethnic group means these ethnic groups are the special social groups. They are in different culture. That means the people, those who live in a particular place in different culture, different language, different culture. That type of people is called a ethnic group. In Belgium, the total population of the Belgium, there are three types of people, social group people who are living in the Belgium. First one, Dutch speaking people, then second one, French speaking, third one, German speaking. This is the social situation of Belgium. That means Belgium, there are three category type of the people, social group of people. They are Dutch speaking people. They are in the 59% of the people were Dutch speaking. Then other 14% of the people, they were French speaking and German. 1% German speaking people. Understand? Belgium is a small European country. Its capital is Brussels. Its frontiers, the borders are France, Netherlands, Luxembourg and Germany. Then the special group, they are living in the special group, ethnic group. Ethnic group means they are the special social group. They are in different culture. They are different culture, different language and different socially they are different. There are three type of people, community. Dutch speaking community 59%, then French speaking community 40% and German speaking community 1%. This is the social situation of the Belgium. All of them understand? Okay. Please listen. Then at that time the portion is very easy. Then you must listen. Then you will read the textbook. At that time you can understand all the things. Okay. Then the Dutch speaking people 59%. So they are always in majority people. Then French speaking people, they are in 40%. They are minority people. Only 1% German speaking people. Then the majority people, they have some majority over the minority. But in case of Brussels, is a language different. Brussels, the capital of the in Brussels, the capital of the city of the Belgium, the case is entirely different. In Belgium, Dutch speaking people is minority people and French speaking people is minority. But in case of quadrant. Then the depth is being indicated only 20%. There is a difference between the capital city and the country. The Belgium, the majority people Dutch speaking. Then the Brussels, the capital city, the French, they are the majority people. Then Dutch, they are the minority. In this case, the Dutch people, they are the majority, and French people, the minority. That is the critical situation in between the Belgium. And also, in Belgium, there are the people from French-speaking people, they were very rich and powerful. That means, especially in case of French-speaking people, they have later get the development in their economic development and educational development. That is the one minus point in the Dutch-speaking people. That means, French-speaking people, they were very rich and they are also very economically developed people. Then, these political tensions makes the total political crisis during the time of 1950 to 1960. Please listen. French speaking people, they are more rich and economic developed people, but the Dutch speaking people, they have get the development of this economic and education development in later. This makes the political tension between the two majority and minority community between them. It makes in the political crisis in 1952 and during the time of 1952 to 1960. Then that is the political crisis. In the case of Brussels is another one. In the capital city, the French speaking people, they were in a majority people, and in the countryside, the Dutch speaking people, they make in a self government. That means there is the governing power in the Belgium. But in the case of French, in the case of Brussels, the French speaking people were more powerful than the Dutch speaking people. This is the political crisis in Brussels. What of the understand? Any doubt? Belgium capital Brussels, then France, Netherlands, Luxembourg and Germany are the borders of this Belgium. There are three types of people, social group people, ethnic group, that is Dutch speaking people in 59%, German speaking people in 40%, and French speaking people in 40%, and German speaking only 1%. Then the political crisis between the team, political tension between these two French speaking and Dutch speaking people will make the political crisis in the time of the political crisis in Belgium. The Brussels, the case is different. French speaking people is more majority and Dutch speaking people is the minority. Then this may be the political tension between the 50s and 60s during the time of the 50s and 60s. Another important country was Sri Lanka. Sri Lanka is a small island of nation in the southern part of Tamil Nadu. Sri Lanka is a small island of nation. The most important thing, the case is not different, same as in the Sri Lanka, like the Belgium. That means there are two types of social group existed there. Which are they? First one is Sinhala group and second one is Tamil speaking community. Sinhala. Yes, Sinhala. Sinhala speaking community. And Tamil speaking community. There are two types of social group existed in Sri Lanka. Then Tamil speaking group is mainly divided into two groups, which are the Sri Lankan Tamil and Indian Tamil. Mainly divided into two groups, Sri Lankan Tamil and the Indian Tamil. Sri Lankan Tamils, they are the natives of Sri Lanka. Then Indian Tamils are the forefathers of Indian. They are come from India and then they come from India and they stay there and they work in the plantation and during the time of colonial period. That means they are forefathers. They are the forefathers of Indians. They come from India, came from India and then stay there and they do their own work in their plantations. That is the Indian Tamil people. There are many Sri Lanka. Sri Lanka is a small island of nation. The southern it is small kilometers away from the southern part of the Tamil Nadu. Then the Sri Lanka speaking, there are two types of social groups, which are Sinhala speaking community and Tamil speaking community. Some Tamil speaking community, they may be divided into native Sri Lankan Tamils and the Indian Tamils. Sri Lankan Tamils are the natives of Sri Lanka and the Indian Tamils are the forefathers of India. That means they are come from India and they stay there and they do their work in their plantation during the time of the colonial period. Understand? All of them understand? Okay. Then, another important thing, the Sri Lankan Tamils, put the Sinhala speaking people were in more cousins than Sinhala speaking people. They were in the majority community. Then Tamils, they were in two groups, that is different categories, and also the most Sinhala speaking peoples, they belong to the Buddhist group. They are mainly their religion is Buddhism, and this Tamil speaking community, they belong to the Hindus and Muslims. Tamil groups, they are belongs to the two category, Hindus and Muslims. But the Sinhala speaking people, they are devotees of the Buddhism. Another important thing is that in Sri Lanka, after 1948, Sri Lanka became independent. At that time, the majority people, that means Sinhala speaking people, they controlled over the domination, they get the domination power of over the Tamil speaking people. That means majoritarianism. They adopted a new way of their power. That is majoritarianism. Majoritarianism means it is the belief that the majority people have the right to rule the government and minority. That means the people, the majority people, they have the right to rule the rule as a dominating power in the government rule, and that means they have the right to rule the government, the minority people, without any concession. That means they did not consider the minority people, and they have only worked for their own will and wish. That is majoritarianism. Majoritarianism means singular people. They rule the minority people, that is Tamil. Tamil speaking community, without any consideration of they did not give any consideration for the will and wish of the Tamil speaking people. That is the majoritarianism. That we today we understand the two main words, then the power sharing, then majoritarianism, and different words. Then the Sinhala people, they have believed that in a group, which group they are, in a social group, they are majority in their power at that time. They have the right to power, to rule the minority without any concession. That means the majority people did not consider any will and wish of any minority people. That is majoritarianism. Then at that time, after 1958, that means the 1958, the Sri Lanka became independent. At that time, the Sinhala speaking people making a new government, and this Sri Lankan government is always pass the policy for in favor of the Sri Lankan Tamil, in favor of Sinhala people. They did not consider the Sri Lankan people. First one, they make new government. Each government they pass the policy or they take the policy with the favor of the Sinhala people. First one. Then second one, in 1956, passed a new act, and then they considered the Sinhala is our official language. First one, they made the new government, and then they are always favor of the policies that are helpful for the Sinhala speaking people. Second one is they made 1956, they passed the new act, then the act helpful for the official language is Sinhala. That means they credited the power of the Tamil language. The Tamil people, they are very disappointed. Why? They are always think that they are not in a they did not get any political rights, any political equality, and any other. In this time we have lost our language. They consider the Sinhala is our language, and there are so many political problems formed in that time. Then another important thing, the main jobs, government jobs, university jobs, and private sector and public sector, different types of all the jobs are, they can get all the jobs are get the Sinhala group. That means they did not get any opportunity for any government job and anywhere in the system. That means the Sinhala people, they have the majority people, they accepted the majoritarianism over the Sri Lankan people. They did not accept the Sri Lankan people, Tamil people, then they are not accepted the Tamil language. They consider the Sinhala as their official language. And another important thing is they did not get any opportunity, job opportunity from anywhere in government section or the official section or in private public sector. They are very disappointed. At that time, they think that they did not get any political equality, and all the political rights are denied by this Sinhala group. That means all the Sinhala groups, they will get the priority in all the ways. The Tamil speaking people, they are considered as language slaves. At that time, they are very confusion. Their political tensions arises. At that time, they wanted big one in a that political freedom for our political state. That means Tamil Elam. Tamil Elam means that we have big one new free. That we have we want our own stage. That means Tamil speaking people, they want their own stage. That is Tamil Elam. That means Tamil state. We want our own state. The Tamil speaking people, they wanted their own state. At that time, it makes the political crisis and it makes leads to the civil war. What do you mean by civil war? Civil war means in a country, two or more groups, they are joined together. The opposition people, they were war together. That means in one country, in different opposite groups, they struggle each other. The majority people and minority people, where they were struggled together, the minority people wants their own rights, their own needs and wishes, but the majority they did not consider. That is the civil war. It leads to the Sri Lankan civil war. At that time, the Sri Lankans, Tamils, they have lost the both sides, the Sri Lankans and the Sinhala people, they have both of them, the many people lost their own lives, and many of the people there are become the refugees, and they can lose their own properties and they become the refugees, and there are so many social, economical and cultural drawbacks were that means the political crisis were at that time the Sri Lanka became very financially bad, then the culturally bad, and then become very poor in the after the civil war. These are the important things. All of you understand? You have any doubts? I want to repeat the main points in Sri Lanka. Sri Lanka is in a small native island. It contains the two type of group people, which are the Sinhala speaking people and the Tamil speaking people. The Sinhala speaking people, they are the majority, and the Tamil speaking people, they are the minority people. Tamil speaking people may be divided into two categories, which are the Sri Lankan Tamil and the Indian Tamils. Sri Lankan Tamils are the natives of the Tamils, and then the Indian Tamils are the Tamils, those who are come from India. They are the forefathers of Indians. They comes from the from India, and they stay there and they do the partition work at the time of the colonial work period. That is then at the time of the mainly the Sinhala groups, they are the Buddhist devotees. Then that means Buddhist Buddhist, they are mainly the Buddhist. Then the mothers are the Hindus, Muslims and the Christians. 47% there the Christians. Then they adopted many new way, the majoritarianism. Majoritarianism means this is a belief that small minority group rule the majority without any consideration of the will and wish of the any minority people. That means they believe that they have the ruling power. Then next one, then some problems are arising in our Sri Lanka. First one, the 1946 Sri Lanka become independent. Then they formed a new government. at that time the government, Sri Lanka government more gave more priority in their Sinhala speaking people. They did not consider the Sri Lankan people, and then they at that time they are making the so many policies in favor of the Sinhala people. They did not consider the Sri Lankan people. The government jobs are the university jobs, our jobs are already given the they get the opportunity, the Sinhala people get the opportunity to get the jobs, but they did not give any consideration for the minority people. At that time there was some social tensions against the minority and majority people. They want their own land, that is the Tamil Eram. We want our own state. Then after this leads to the civil war. Civil war, the some of the peoples, they are in a country, the different opposites groups of the people, they are struggled together. That is the civil war. In civil war, this leads to the more in both sides. That means the Tamils and the Sinhalas, they are lost their own lives. Most of the people, the lot of the people lost their own lives, and some drawbacks will be come soon. That means the political, social and cultural problems are arising in our Sri Lanka. All of you understand? Okay. If you have any doubt, you please inform me, and also I can manage them.